We are ready for our next extra practice worksheet for math 2331 linear algebra. This worksheet covers some of the material in sections 5.4, 6.1, and 6.2, which is least squares and determinants. So we begin with number one. We want to find a least squares solution to AX equals B. We are given A and given B. Well, what we want here is the normal equation, which is A transpose A times X equals A transpose B. We know that the solutions to this will be our least squares solutions. So let's calculate here A transpose A. When we transpose A, the first column becomes the first row, and then the second column becomes the second row. And then I'll recopy matrix A. Now, when I multiply, you see the size here, this is a 2x2 matrix. We get 3, and then this entry, we have 1 minus 1 plus 1, which is 1. And similarly, the 2, 1 entry will be positive 1. And then finally, this 2, 2 entry, we have 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 3. So you notice this matrix is symmetric. Necessarily, it will be. And then we can also calculate A transpose B, which would be this product. Now, when I multiply, I will have a vector 2x1, and I get 8 plus 2, which is 10, and then I get 8 minus 2, which is 6. Okay, so my normal equation, maybe I will write this up here. We have A transpose A times vector X, and this will equal A transpose B. This is the normal equation. So let's solve. Well, the thing is, for this example, you see A transpose A is invertible, so we can calculate its inverse. A transpose A inverse. Well, this will be 1 over. The determinant here is 9 minus 1. And then when we find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix, we flip the diagonals. This would be 3 and 3, and then take negative of the off diagonals. So altogether here, I get 3 over 8, and then minus 1 over 8, minus 1 over 8, and 3 over 8. I could have also left the 1 over 8 outside, but it's perfectly fine. So let's solve now. My least squares solution, X star, will be, we just take this, A transpose A inverse, I will put this here, copy and paste, and then times this vector 10, 6. What happens when I multiply this matrix by this vector? Well, we get 30 minus 6, which is 24, and 24 over 8 is 3. We have minus 10 plus 18, which is 8. So we have 8 over 8. So this entry is 1. So this is my answer here in letter A. This is my least square solution. Part B says calculate the orthogonal projection of the vector B, we still see it, it's right here, onto the image of A. Now it looks like I'm going to have to do things unrelated to this question. It looks like maybe I have to do Gram-Schmidt on the columns of A, and then we could project using that orthonormal basis. But if we use the concepts here, we can calculate this quickly because we know, maybe I will write this, we know the projection onto the image of A of vector B is AX star. This is how we get our least squared solution. And so I can just multiply matrix A. We take matrix A, which I can copy and paste. Here's matrix A times this vector. This is the projection. This is really where the least squares solution comes from. So now let me scroll up. So this vector, AX star, we get 4, 3 plus 1, we have 3 minus 1, and then 3 plus 1. So this is my projection. This is my answer in letter B. Now the third part, we compute the least squares error. This is the shortest distance that B can be from any point in the image of A. And so it's a length. What we want is a length. First, let's just compute B minus AX star. Then we can calculate its length. But you see we have AX star. Maybe I'll write that one first. This is 4, 2, 4. And then the vector B was given in the problem. This was 8, 2, 0. 8, 2, 0. We can just subtract these two vectors. I get 4, 0, minus 4. 4, 0, minus 4. And now I can compute the length of B minus AX star. This is a square root of 16 plus 16, which, let's see, I can factor a 4 out here. It's square root of 32, which is 4 square root 2. This will be my least squares error. So this is this least squares problem number one. Now we move on to determinants. This is from section 6.2 and 6.1. First, we're given a 4x4 matrix, find the determinant, and then we're asked some other questions about it. Now we need to be able to calculate determinants with cofactors and calculate determinants with row operations. You could just start doing cofactors here. However, I can simplify this as a first step, because you see, in the first row, in the third row, three of the entries are the same. So my very first step here, which will make my life a lot easier, is I can just say subtract row one from row three. I will get this determinant, 1 by 4, 1, 0, 1, 2, 0. And then I will have 2, 0, 0, 0. And then the last one is -6, 2, 2, 0. Okay, that was doing one row operation. Now I will do cofactors. Okay, I would expand about the third row because I have a row of all zeros and one non-zero entry. Well, the sign here, this one's plus, minus, plus. So we're going to have plus 2, or you could write it this way, minus 1. This is in row 3, column 1. You see this will be positive. And then we have 2. Now we will have times another determinant. This will come, we cross off this row, cross off this column. And you see what I'm left with? 5, 4, 1, 1, 2, 0, 2, 2, 0. Let's write that. We have 5, 4, 1, 1, 2, 0, 2, 2, 0. Well, you see, now I can expand about this third column. Maybe I should write plus 0 here. But when I expand about this third column, we have 2, okay? Then this one is plus, minus, plus, or you could write it as minus 1 to the row 1, column 3. Then I have this next determinant. I cross off this column, cross off this row. 1, 2, 2, 2. 1, 2, 2, 2. Now we're almost finished. I have 2 times, this will be 2 minus 4. So altogether, you see my determinant is negative 4. I use cofactors, but I also started with an initial row operation to simplify the steps here. For part B, we're moving into properties. We have determinant of A as minus 4. Then, well, we know the determinant of a transpose is the same thing as determinant of A. And so this determinant, this will break into determinant A, determinant A, determinant A, or I will write it this way. This will be determinant of A cubed. Here, well, determinant of A is minus 4. And so we get minus 4 cubed, which is negative 64. Next one, we want the determinant of minus 3 times A inverse. One thing we know, let's first write the determinant of A inverse. This will be 1 over the determinant of A. But then when I multiply minus 3, we have to remember that the determinant is linear in each row separately. It's called multilinear. I have 4 rows, so this will be minus 3 to the 4th power times 1 over negative 4. And 3 to the 4th is 81, so I get minus 81 divided by 4. Part C, B is a 4x4 matrix with determinant of B equal to 0. Is the product AB invertible? The determinant of A times B, they're the same size. And so this will be determinant A times determinant B, which will be minus 4 times 0, which is 0. So the answer is no. This product, A times B, is not invertible because its determinant is 0. Last question. We are given A is 2x3 and B is 3x2. Is it necessarily the case that the determinant of A times B equals the determinant of B times A? Now, note that this is not a square matrix and B is also not a square matrix. So unlike above right here, where I could break the determinant of a product into a product of determinants, I cannot do that here because A and B, well, they're not square. Okay, the answer here is no, but let's talk about why. So I can come up with an example as to no, and we can see what's happening here. So let's let A, we need 2 rows and 3 columns. We will take 1, 0, 0, 1, and 0, 0. Okay, and then we can also take B. In fact, I will take B to be a transpose. It's fine. It will be some 3-row and 2-column matrix. We have 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Now, we can calculate AB. We can calculate BA. Well, AB here, this is the 2x2 identity. You can either multiply this out, or you can realize this matrix has orthonormal columns, and this product is really B transpose B, which will be the identity. This comes from our discussion in 5.2 and 5.3. So you notice here the determinant of AB is 1. So I claim the determinant of BA is 0. You can see it a few ways. One is you can think about rank. This matrix is 3x3 and has rank no more than 2 because of the sizes of these two matrices. That's one way to see the determinant must be 0, or rank 2, 3x3 matrix will not be invertible. Determinant is 0. If you don't want to think like that, we can just calculate this matrix. What is this 3x3 matrix? Well, I'm multiplying B times A. And so if I take B times the first column, it's just the first column of B. So I get 1, 0, 0. Now take B times the second column. This gives us the second column of B, which is 0, 1, 0. And now we take B times the third column, and this is 0. So we get 0, 0, 0. And now we can very clearly see that the determinant of BA is 0. We could, well, we have a row of zeros, for example. Determinant is 0 here. So this is an example of where this fails. The determinant of AB is not equal to the determinant of BA here. Well, this is the end of our extra practice worksheet. Thank you so much.